Jim, and thanks Nick for the report. And what this report is a rationale on why the council should be disclosing to the potential third party, all of which seems very sensible from the report that's been presented. From here to want to agree with everything Councillor Kemp has previously said, he took this report, the reason this report is here is because he and his little Democratic group asked for a report to come to the table. And I thought that was really useful, because I, like all of us, have read in the press about this this development and how this development has cost us allegedly millions of pounds. So I think in the report, I'm conscious of your comments, Chair, on our terms of reference, and I'm trying to stick to the report and what it is. You told us you put a valuation on it. Are you able, Nick, to tell us if the sale proceeds on these figures, and taking into account grant funding, how much we as a council will have lost on this development here? Does that make sense?
We are an audit committee. It is our role
absolutely goal is to try and get answers to some of the questions. And I accept there's a thin line between scrutiny and all that. Of course, I accept that. And that's why I preface it by saying this report is clearly a rationale on what we should do with the site now. And I endorse that. Not a problem. Well, how on earth is this committee going to make any assessment? We are, as elected members, we are challenged, we are questioned, we are berated by the public and called idiots for losing all this money on it. I just want to know, have we lost money? If so, how have we lost money? And if so, whose fault is it?
I accept your point, Councillor. I think that there is some work being done more generally around scrutiny and work programmes and where things are appropriately asked and stuff like that. But I guess I make my point again in relation to the terms of this committee. I'm going to take Councillor Stone.
Sorry, it's just in relation to that last point and the previous presentation that we had, which was on lessons learned, and you know, it spoke very clearly about the cost, what needed to happen, you know, the things that we would change in the future. And I think being said that this lessons learned would be available by February, so perhaps that's the way forward in bringing that type of report to this committee, and then the housing scrutiny is the appropriate place to look at all those other questions.
Thank you, Councillor. That's helpful. Councillor Kemp.
Thank you. As I said before, I want to make it clear that I'm not objecting to any of the recent actions to try and remedy the situation by our officers, and that's why we proposed them for cabinet. This has got to be sorted out. But if you turn to page 117, you can see where we're going to lose money and by how much. Because the basic assumptions of the council we're talking about 23 properties, that the capital value of the furnished of the house was 184,000, and that the market value of the house is 139,000. So my query about the process, bearing in mind that we didn't pay anything for these shell properties because they were bought under the housing market renewal initiative, is that someone at some stage, not these officers, but at some stage, should have realised that the tender to improve the properties was greater than their eventual market value. And that therefore they could have looked at other options for dealing with this. If they wanted housing to be there, at that sort of price, they could have demolished and built new for that figure. So what I'm trying to understand is, where's the trigger point at which, even with the best intentions, someone
detailed scrutiny, shouldn't say scrutiny, it's the wrong term to use, it's that that's a detailed assurance that you can then get.